Welcome to Meet the GIMP. Today's tutorial is not about raw converting, but about new coding while doing a real show and to correct some errors from the last tutorial. I want to tell you something about this image. I have made some additional changes while recording the show. As you can see, the sea is a bit dull and it's just gray with not much definition in it. And when I switch off the sea layer here and the other layers, you can see there is some definition in the sea. And when I look at the layer mask, you can see that I used a layer mask which is mostly gray for the area I wanted to show. So let's redo this step again. I have deleted the sea layer and made a copy of the background layer. I named the layer as sea and placed that layer below the sky and above the land. I could have worked with the layer I had, but I wouldn't have got a good result because I had used the curves tool to get the sea a bit darker, and with that I have destroyed a lot of color information which was present in that layer, and I will get a better result this way here. Now, I again add a layer mask to the sea layer. I use the grayscale copy of the layer and add it. I click on Show Layer Mask and edit the layer mask. I will use the Curves tool and I will repeat the same procedure by pulling this down. But this time, I will pull this upper curve up. Now, I have a layer mask which is nearly white for the area of the sea and sky and nearly black for the area of land. To correct some missing structure here, I select the brush tool and choose a bigger brush here and start painting the land area with black color. I don't want to paint the sea layer with black color, so I exchange the foreground and background color and go to the sea area and start painting with white color. And I think I should do this a bit softer. This area here, I think it was quite well, but you can correct that later on. So let's choose a soft brush and see that we get this edge here fine. When I disable Show Layer Mask, we can see the stretch seam here on the border between land and sea. Let's zoom into the image and you can see there is a halo where the layer mask and the layer don't work together, and I will work on it later. Now I go back to the full image with Shift Control E. I select the curves tool and check if I have layer mask selected, and I include the sky layer to see the whole image. And now I click into the image and play with the curves. Now you can see the halo between the sea and the land vanishes. But the sea is now again bit dull. But I can pull the curve up here and I get a clear sea here. And I think I shouldn't overdo it. I can see the sunshine on the sea, the shadow of the clouds, different wave structure, and a bit blue color as it should be on the sea. There is a bit problem with the bright stuff at the edge of the sky because sky is too brightened up, and I can solve that problem in later steps. Okay, I can adjust with the opacity slider the effect of curves tool, and I think I should make it a bit less for a good effect. A tip from John Arnold's broadcast says that we should go to the full possible amount and then go down with the slider, because it is much easier to see the effect when you go down, and we can decide the right amount easily. And I think I have done too much with this part, so I slide the slider down, and I think this is okay. From where does this bright stuff comes on the horizon? I deselect the sky layer and check, but it's not because of it. So I deselect the sea layer, and it's because of sea layer. And I have to darken this part here. And for doing that, I use the gradient tool. I select the layer mask and now select the gradient tool from the toolbox. And I want to have the land part white and sky part black, and I want to have the border here. The gradient starts with full white and ends with black. So I zoom into this part. I select the gradient tool and start around here. While making the line, I am pressing Ctrl key and left mouse button and pulling in order to get a straight line, and leave the button here. You see, it worked. The brightness on the horizon is gone, and you can see that the layer mask of the land is gone too. Let's have a look at the whole image. And you can see all our edits are gone. So this wasn't the good way to deal with the horizon. So I undo this step here. Now first I select the rectangle and check if layer mask is selected, and draw the rectangle in the sky part. Now, when the rectangle is drawn, I can do edit work inside it, and rest of the layer mask will not be affected. Now, I again do the same procedure. Zoom into the bright part here and select the layer mask. I want to have black above and white below. So I start from here, go straight up to the horizon, and now you can see the sea is only white and land and sky are black. Shift, Control, A. Disable all selections. Shift, Control, E. Goes back to the whole image. And a lot better now. I want to edit the sky layer in the same way like I did for the land layer. Just double the sky layer and switch to overlay mode. This is way too much. So I pull down the opacity slider a bit and we have a bit more contrast in the sky. And now I think the image is nearly ready except for one thing. This wall of the house here is way too dark. This is the case for dodging and burning. Dodging and burning is a term out of the darkroom days where you can dodge a picture by keeping your hand or paper or something else in the light beam of the enlarger, between the enlarger and photographic paper. And burning is opposite of that. There you take a paper and cut a hole in a specific form into it and so edit some light to some other parts of the image. It's quite tedious procedure to figure out which step to be done at what time. And you need a lot of sheets of paper for that. And when you want to look at such a process, I recommend you to look a film, Well Photographer. It's a film about James and it's a terrific film even without this, a dark chamber scene. I can really recommend you that film. Now, let's see dodging and burning process. We have a dodge and burn tool in the toolbox here, but I would like to work again with layers. I add one more layer and I want to fill it with white. I go to color channel and I keep 50% for gray and 128% in other channel. This gray color is 50% gray and I switch the layer mode to overlay and you can see nothing has happened. Now I switch the colors to black and white and select a brush. This brush size is about right, but I decrease the opacity to let's say 30% or so. Now I make sure that I have the new layer selected and change the foreground color to white and background color to black. And I start to paint the wall here. And perhaps you can see it, that the compression has done its work and the side of the wall is brightens up. This process is called dodging because I am keeping the light on the photographic paper and so the wall gets brighter. When we look at the layer here, you can see that I have a whiter area here and there are some other parts of the image which could be a bit lighter. For example, the rocks near the shore. The best way would be zooming into the image and I can see that now I have made the wall brighter and the structure is nearly gone due to the JPEG compression. But I can repair that by switching the color, and shortcut key for that is X key, and make it a bit darker here. I should pull the opacity slider a bit down, and this is okay. I think the horizon is very bright, so I adjust the circle size of the brush to paint that part and use black color to darken that part of the image. I can work through the image with changing the color with X key and make it a bit darker. I think that was too much and I am not so sure about what I am doing there. So undo the step. You can see the technique that I made a layer and made it medium gray and 128% for each channel and change the layer mode to overlay. Medium gray and overlay mode does nothing and you can paint into the image with white or black. While painting with white, you make the image a bit brighter. With black, you make it darker. I think now this image is really finished with editing. I wouldn't work again on it, except some of you find some mistake in the edits I have made today. I hope I haven't done that and name the layer as Dodge and Burn. That was it for today. If you want to send a comment, please write to info@meetthegimp.org. And for more information, go to meetthegimp.org. I would like to hear from you. Tell me what you liked, what I could have made better, what you want to see in future. This is Hemant Vaidande, dubbing for the Spoken Tutorial Project.